Autoscope Ignition Timing Testing, Script PX. One of the main malfunctions of the ignition system are disturbed ignition timing. In older vehicles, the ignition timing is adjusted using a distributor. The ignition timing must occur earlier, with increasing engine RPM. This is because the speed of the combustion in the engine cylinder is fairly constant with constant cylinder pressure and constant air/fuel ratio. The advance is done mechanically, using a centrifugal advance mechanism, consisting of springs and flyweights. Since the speed of combustion does change with cylinder pressure, a device called a vacuum advance will advance the ignition timing with manifold vacuum and delay or retard the ignition timing if the engine is under heavy load, with the throttle open and manifold vacuum very low. Install a pressure transducer instead of a spark plug. Connect the high voltage wire to the high voltage spark gap. Attach a sync probe to the wire. In the USB Autoscope program menu, select the PX35 mode. Start the engine. Turn on the signal recording. We observe on the screen the signal from the in-the-cylinder pressure transducer and the signal of the sync pulse. The software automatically determines the ignition timing and engine speed. Slowly press the accelerator pedal. We observe a change in the ignition timing on an unloaded engine, low loads. After decelerating and idling stabilization, we make a sharp throttle, heavy loads. This allows to test the operation of the centrifugal regulator. We turn off the ignition. On the screen, we observe in cylinder pressure waveform. Run the signal processing using the PX script. We see the results of the analysis tab on the screen. Here we can see the change in the ignition timing when the engine is loaded. On the left is the range of angles, ignition timing, what should be the angles at different engine speeds. Right, measured angles on a specific vehicle. As you can see, the test showed the ignition timing system in a good condition. Let's take a closer look at the graph of the ignition timing changing. To do this, go to the ignition timing tab. We observe three zones. Green rectangle, this area should be the idle ignition timing. Red zone, in this zone, there should be a graph of the ignition timing with a loaded engine, high loads. Green zone, in this zone, there should be a graph of the ignition timing with an unloaded engine, low loads. With the help of a marker, we can track the dependence of the ignition timing on the speed and load on the engine. The centrifugal regulator is responsible for the correction of the revolutions. As the RPMs increase, the ignition timing also increases. The vacuum corrector is responsible for the correction of the load. On the graph, the load is displayed in different colors of the points, low green, high red. For example, at 3500 RPM, the ignition timing at high loads is 25 degrees and at low loads is 38 degrees. To control, you can turn off different sections of the loads. This graph corresponds to a serviceable distributor. We see that while engine speed increases, the ignition timing does not change on this graph. The reason is a stuck or seized centrifugal advance mechanism. In this example, we observe a serviceable centrifugal regulator. But the vacuum regulator does not work. For example, at 3000 RPM the angle is almost the same. The reason is a faulty vacuum regulator. In this example, we can see that the ignition timing does not change either from the load or from the engine speed. The reason is the malfunction of both systems. In modern injector systems, the engine control unit, ECU, is responsible for setting the ignition timing based on the firmware and the readings of the sensors, including the NOx sensor. As each spark plug often has its own ignition coil, the engine control unit can control the ignition timing of each cylinder individually. Here is an example of a working ignition timing of a car equipped with fuel injection system. Here are examples of faulty ignition timing systems of cars equipped with fuel injection system.